Before we look at creating a copy geometry feature, I'll first show you a publish geometry feature. Warning, I'm going to use the common Creo parametric slang copy geom to refer to copy geometry features and publish geom for publish geometry features. Publish geoms are created in a model and contain surfaces, edge chains, datum features, and annotations from that model. Then, in another model, a copy geom will grab this published geom as an external reference for making other features. I want to stress that published geoms are not required for copy geoms. In fact, they are not required for top-down design or Creo Parametric. We use them for convenience, either to help ourselves or help others. It's a great way of identifying and isolating for others the references that they need to create geometry later. Published geoms can be created in part models, often a skeleton or a master model. They can be created in assemblies, but can reference only assembly-level geometry like surfaces or datums, but not geometry from components or assembly-level cuts or holes. Also, to improve regeneration, place them as high up in the model tree as possible. Let's jump into Creo Parametric. Here I have a transmission assembly, and one of my coworkers needs to design the parts that this interfaces with, so to help them out, I'm going to create a publish geometry feature. First, I will open up the model in which I'm going to create the publish geometry feature. To execute the command, you can get to it on the model tab right from the model intent overflow menu, but if you click on the tools tab, it's available right in the ribbon. And so here we have the publish geometry dialog box. There are three different collectors in here. First off, I can select the surfaces that I want, and I'm just going to hold down the control key in order to pick them. To the right of the collector is a details button, and this will list the different surfaces that you've selected. Plus, if you click on the add button, it'll allow you to construct surface sets. The next collector is for edge chains, and so I can click right in the collector to activate it. And this time I'm actually going to use the details button. If I change to rule based, then I can select an edge. And then if I click complete loop, it'll grab all the edges around that surface. Third collector is for references, and this allows me to select datum features, such as datum planes and coordinate systems, also points and axes. There is an edit button down here to the right of annotations, and if you have any 3D annotations, this allows you to grab those as well. So I'll click the OK button. There is a properties tab from which you can rename the feature, and I highly recommend that you do this so that people know what the publish geometry feature is for. I hit the check mark, and the feature is created. You can see it down here at the bottom of my model tree. And if you can move it higher in the model tree, that'll help regeneration. Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoyed this video.